Someone who doesn't cower away. Mm-hmm. That's for a few
Doesn't
things.
Cower away. That's good.
That's huge. Doesn't cower away.
All right. So today we are here with Andrea again, and we're going to be talking about a subject that I think is a pretty important one. Not just important, but it's something that's not talked about a lot. Because in today's society with like feminism and a lot of the Me Too movement, you see a lot in the news, there's a lot of negativity towards being a man or being masculine and stuff like that. But there are also a lot of really good qualities. So we're here with Andrea, and we're going to talk about all the stuff that makes men great, the stuff that she likes about men. And we're going to focus specifically on like things that she can't get from, like, say, another woman or for herself. Because
I like men.
Because I think you're a great example of like someone who's, you're very independent. I mean, you're pretty, you're good looking, you're like on top of your shit. Don't get a hothead. You're a person that like they would look at, and they a lot of guys think, okay, what could I provide this woman that she can't get from herself? Well, for a long time, men were the providers in the relationship. They were the ones with the jobs, but you don't need a guy to do that for you. You can do that for yourself. And I've seen you, you know, not only do that, but travel by yourself, do a lot of things by yourself. So what do you get from men that you can't just get from yourself? Besides, you know,
the D. Okay, so besides the D, good question. What do guys provide? Well, I love and affection, right?
Yeah.
Giving me attention or their undivided attention when we're hanging out, right? If I'm going out and traveling on my own, I can't share that with anyone. So yeah. I want to share that emotion with someone.
Mm-hmm.
Or feel protected.
Yeah. You mentioned that a couple times, protection.
Protection.
And that's a good thing because it's like, you know, that's something that you don't necessarily need.
Mm-hmm.
You don't need a guy protecting you at all points in time because you're very capable yourself.
But I want, that's the thing.
But that's what you, yeah, that's what you want.
I want. I don't need it, sure, but it'd be better if I had someone there to make me feel safe, mm-hmm. make me feel protected. Like, yeah, throw me in a bar and someone calls me a bad name, I'm gonna knock them out. But it would be a lot nicer instead of me throwing some punches,
yeah.
a guy, you,
you
know,
had a man to back you up.
Man to back me up or make me feel like, oh, he cares about me.
Right.
That's like really attractive to me is mm-hmm. that they care enough about me as a person to want to do something to make me feel like I'm special enough to preserve or protect. And
yeah, for sure.
Yeah. I think anyone wants that, right? Is to feel special or feel like they mean something to somebody.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and a little bit, not only like verbally, but physically.
Yeah.
The nice arms. They don't have to have like super big muscles or anything, but I think just knowing that they're there and they can protect me and hold me.
Yeah.
I want to be cuddled. I love cuddles. I'll be Big Spoon if I have to. But I want.
But you prefer to be the
be...
little spoon, right?
Well, yeah. Everyone preserves.
I wonder if there's any women out there that like to be the big spoon.
Sometimes I do if it's hot because then I can just.
I can just like, back out if
I
you need
can
to.
Control. Yeah, how the uh-huh. temperature is, but yeah, to make me feel safe.
You're backing up.
Am I?
You keep moving back. I think that's what it is.
No, I don't.
Because you're secretly trying to get out of the camera.
You
secretly don't like the spotlight.
So
you're like inching back.
I do.
I'm gonna catch you on it next time.
Fine.
Yeah. So one thing that you mentioned before that I actually want to talk about is consistency.
Mm-hmm.
What about consistency do you like, and how does that look?
Yeah.
In a relationship. So it's a very topical conversation.
A very topical conversation. I think it goes back to reliability, and I can depend on you,
mm-hmm.
and you're showing me that no matter what happens, you can be the person that I know that you can be, that's
right.
valuable to the relationship, and that we find both attractive.
How many bikes are there here? Everyone has a bike.
It's a lot. It's a nice day.
Everyone has a bike. So that's interesting that you mentioned that because a lot of this has been kind of the tale that's oldest time. Masculine and feminine energy, they're different. I was telling you before, which is that a lot of the deities that we consider feminine, like the earth or nature, Mother Nature, they change. They can be unpredictable at times. But the masculine energy is usually more consistent. Like the sun is almost always a masculine figure because he rises in, at the same time. The moon is feminine too because it changes. It changes a little bit differently.
And maybe that's also why.
There's phases. There's phases of the moon, yeah. And women experience phases too.
A lot of times.
Yeah. So,
out of our control.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, it's a real thing.
Yeah.
It's always a volatile emotion, and that's why it's attractive for somebody else to keep that consistency, because we're riding the waves on our own time.
Right.
It's nice to have something that we can rely on,
mm-hmm.
that we know is going to be stable.
Yeah, exactly. we talked a little bit about you like when a guy shows you attention, but is there a point where he shows too much attention and then it becomes bad?
Yes. I think if it's early on in the relationship, I want someone to show me that he cares. I want someone to do that, but I also need to trust that it's because he knows who I am.
Yeah.
And personally, I don't think you can...
So you don't like it when a guy goes in too quick because you think he's making, an irrational decision.
Exactly. I don't trust the decision because I haven't shared enough for you to feel like that. you don't know me,
yeah,
right? I don't know you and you don't know me. So if you're being that forward with me already, that means you might be doing that to anybody else because it's just a girl in front of you. You don't really, you know, you haven't...
Literally all he knows is that you're pretty and you have a vagina.
Yeah, and some boobs.
And some boobs, yeah.
Yeah, so for me, it's like, well, you're not ready to make that decision. And it's also kind of a decision-making process. So if he's just, attracted to the next thing that he sees, then for me, it's like, oh, he's going to fly away like a little butterfly.
Yeah, it's not a reliable... Again, that's back to reliability.
Someone who doesn't cower away, that's for a few
things. Doesn't cower away, that's good.
That's huge.
Doesn't cower away. How do you notice that? And what do you see when, let's say you're out on a date, how would you know if that guy is gonna be a little bitch?
Little bitch?
for lack of a better term.
I think it's hard to say on the first date. I think that's something that comes out with a lot of different actions. If you're bringing a topic that's sensitive to you, or to me, to a guy, and they're kind of shying away or dodging a question, right? They're pivoting from what the answer could be, whether it's good or bad. That's a little sign of cowardness to me, because you're not facing...
You're not standing your ground.
You're not standing your ground.
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever it is, it's you're hiding from the question.
Yeah.
What it could come out to be. I think that's a part of it. And not taking ownership for your actions. So if you did something, not everyone's going to be perfect, but if you can help the other person understand why maybe you did that, that's helpful. But if you just completely ignore it, you're a coward. you're a coward.
You know what's one thing that I recommend guys do? Can you come closer? One of the things that this concept called breaking rapport, which is where you're talking to someone and a lot of times people, they instinctively want to get along. They want to have the same, oh, I like that too, or that's, that's awesome. But a lot of times when people disagree about something, that's where you can really see that person's character. You know what I mean? And so sometimes I'll recommend that a guy kind of intentionally do this where he says something that, isn't always the nicest thing, but it shows you kind of who he is and how he reacts in the situation. And if he stands his ground, then it shows you that he's, also he's being authentic and honest, but he's not a complete pussy too.
Yeah, or a pushover, because that's huge too, right? You want someone authentic. And if it just so happens that everything is aligning and you guys are agreeing, that's fine, but say something a little bit extra or something more that kind of shows why you yourself believe that particular position or why you like that particular thing versus just saying exactly what the other person is saying. Because, you don't want someone who's exactly like you. You want to be able to have that conversation. And it goes back to the trust thing, too. It's well, can I trust what you're saying? Because really, you're just taking the words out of my mouth.
Absolutely.
Same thing.
Absolutely. Okay, cool. Well, I think we got a lot of stuff. I think this was a good talk. Anyway, thanks for watching, you guys. We'll bring Andrea on another video at some point.
See.
Not sure when. All right, cool.